Via my YouTube channel, I'm sharing some of the basic concepts of cloud computing and especially with respect to Google Cloud Platform. In this video, we are going to see about virtual private cloud. So what is virtual private cloud? Virtual private cloud is a private entity within a Google Cloud platform, which enables the user to create and deploy resources in a private secured environment. So if you want to deploy an application, you can deploy in three different ways. One is you can deploy the application in public cloud. Second, you can deploy it in a private cloud. Third, you can deploy it in a hybrid cloud. So here the application can be accessed and deployed in a private environment, which is highly secure. So VPC is a global resource, which is within the Google Cloud Platform service. Okay, VPC has a concept called subnets. So within the virtual private cloud, we can build individual subnets on regional basis. For example, if there are 13 regions, for each and every region we can have a subnet. So within the subnet we can have zonal wise subdivision too, so that our application can be accessed globally without any failure. Okay, so how does these resources communicate with each other? The communication happens via internal IPv4 address. Okay, why do we need a VPC? The reason why we need VPC is for a secured environment. VPC cannot communicate to the outside environment, or no access can be done inside the VPC without the proper authentication. Each and every resources within the VPC has its own firewall, and we can enable it so that all the transactions within and to and fro within the VPC can be observed. This is one reason. Okay, the second reason is load balancing. For example, if you are going to have an application that is being accessed globally, you need to make sure that the load is equally distributed across the server, or else if one server is getting dumped, then the server may have the chance of going down and the service can be interrupted. So in order to have a steady and equal distribution of load balancing, VPC is being used. Third important thing is high availability. For example, if one region goes down, the other region has to take and respond to the request. So if it is a single region, if the application is deployed within a single region, if it is goes down, application will not be available for the user. If the load is increased and if the request has increased the threshold. So in order to have high availability environment where the request is being served without any interruption, we need to have a VPC and we need to have a proper communication between the regions in the VPC, that is communication between the subnets. So this is the basic concept about VPC. In my future videos, I'll explain in detail about VPC. So if you have any questions about this video or about VPC, you can post it in the comment box. Thank you. Have a great day.